Hello everyone, welcome to Exam CTZ. This is Uma Maheshwar. Today we are going to discuss percentages part 2. So these are some more questions asked in SA 2019, both AP and Telangana. I'm mixing the questions and I'm just doing it. So let's see the questions.
See this question. In a fraction, if the numerator is increased by 23%, and the denominator is decreased by 32%, we get new fraction, which is 13 by 17. Then the sum of new fraction and the original fraction is, let the original fraction be x by y. You are increasing the numerator by 23%, which means 123. Denominator, you are decreasing it by 32, which means you are multiplying it by 68%, so that you are getting 13 by 17. So you can say 17 ones up, 17 fours up. So x by y is equals to, the original fraction is 52 by 123. And the new fraction is 13 by 17. Sum of the new fraction and the original fraction. So you have 52 by 123. Plus the original new fraction is 13 by 17. You can common 13 and do it. Or else try to figure out your denominator. Your denominator will be multiple of 123 and 17. Therefore, just simply multiply 123 into 17. 17 threes are 51, 17 twos are 34, plus 5, 39. So 17 plus 3, 2091. 2109 cannot be your answer. 2109 cannot be your answer. 2091, 2901 cannot be your answer. So look at, by looking at the denominator, you can answer. So don't waste your time by finding the numerator. So this is a simple trick to eliminate. Actually, you can find your answer by taking 13 as common. You can do rest of the thing, just add fraction. But the short way is to figure out the denominator, because all the denominators are simply same. The total number of students in a class with 44 girls and rest 45% boys. 45% boys, the meaning is, girls are 55%, so indirectly he is telling you 55% is 44. Cancel it in 11 table, 11 5s, 5% is 4. Multiply it by 20, so 100% is simply 80 members. So total number of members are 80. In a school, the ratio of number of boys and girls is 3 is to 2. If 30% of boys and 20% of the girls are scholarship holders, the percentage of the students that do not get the scholarships is. In a school, the ratio of number of boys and girls is given. Now see, when you are adding two groups, again it goes like grouping, and we know the formula, like N1A1 plus N2A2 by N1 plus N2. So N1A1 plus N2A2 by N1 plus N2 will give you the direct answer. So see, first of all, how many of them were the scholarship holders? 3 parts is 30, 2 parts is 20. N1A1 90, N2A2 40 by 5. 130 by 5 gives you 26% are scholarship holder. So these hold the scholarship, therefore 74% do not get scholarships. So he's asking you how many percent of the students that do not get scholarship, therefore 74% do not get scholarships. 55% of 880 is 80 more than 4 by 5th of x. So I can say 80 more than 4 by 5th of x is 4 by 5th of x plus 80. Which is equals to 55% of 880. You can say 4 by 5th of x is equals to 80, you send it there in common. 55 by 100 into 80, if you common it will be 11 minus 1. 5 11s are 20s are. So you're getting 4 by 5th of x is equals to 80, 20 you take common in the denominator. 121 minus 20 will be 101. 4 1s are 4 20s are. 20, 20 cancel. X is equals to 101 into 5. Simply 505. They have given a table here. School, P, Q, R, S are the schools. Number of students passing in the examination, 360, 520, 540 and 420. Pass percentage is also given. The meaning is 20% is 360, 80% is 580 and so on. He is asking you the total number of students appeared in the examination. So if 20% is 360 means 10% is 180, which means total members is 1800 in school P. 80% is 520 means, you know, 20% becomes 130. So 20% is 130 means, add 20% to this, so it becomes 650. 90% is 540. So if you divide 54 by 9, it will be 6. Therefore, it must be 600. 7, 6 up. Again, this is also 600. Therefore, total number of members in all the schools, if you add everything, so it will be 50. 6, 6, 6. It will be 18. 18 plus 18, 36. So total number of members in the school is 3,650. Thank you and subscribe to the channel Exams A to Z for more videos.